Hi, welcome back. My name is Gigi. If you're new to this video, I'm a hairdresser. I've been a hairstylist for a few number of years. Let's leave it at that. But today I'm going to talk to you about how to do a treatment on chemically treated hair, bleached hair. So when you bleach the hair, it ends up getting very porous, especially long hair. So in order to avoid that happening, you need to maintain it at home. That's very important. You don't want your hair to be breaking off. You don't want it, if you have curly hair, you don't want it to get frizzy. If you have straight hair, you don't want it to get very brittle and very dull. So I'm gonna show you what is it that I use at the salon with my customers and what works for me. So we start off with an oil that we put from mid-length to ends. I always say you don't put it on your scalp because your scalp really, the hair that's near your scalp really doesn't get dry because of your natural oils really keeps the hair healthy. So this is simulating that. So this is how we're gonna use the oil. Let me show you. I go ahead and I part my hair in two, like this. I grab the oil and then I spray. You don't have to use too much product. More does not mean better. More means that you're just wasting product, and you don't. When you invest in these products, you want to make sure that you don't overuse it, because professional products are very concentrated, so you don't have to do too much, okay? Remember that. Okay, you go ahead, and then you do the same on this side. Okay, you work it through. If you have some bleach higher than what I'm showing you, go ahead and whatever you have left over, especially in the front, right now that they're getting that look that you have more of highlights around the face, then put some on that bleached hair, on that pre-lightened hair. Okay, once you're done, you can either A, use a scrunchie. I sometimes do it before I go to bed. And I do it all the way up, and I put like a little towel over my pillowcase, and then I go to sleep. And it's fine if you don't use too much. You go ahead and you clip it, and again, you put a heating cap. If you don't have time, you leave it 5 minutes while you're getting everything together before you go to the shower or you work out or if you go to the beach. But this is, you can even braid it with this oil. You can do a French braid and then come back after the beach or the pool and then go ahead and shampoo it. So this is what you do first. Yes. Then you go ahead and you shampoo it. I use the hydrating shampoo. This is what I recommend on my customers too as well. When they're at home. At the salon, I use a clarifying shampoo, but today we're gonna use a hydrating shampoo. So I already shampooed my hair. I gave it two shampoos. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to apply the protein first, and then I'm gonna put the conditioner over it. So it goes together. You leave these two in the shower. You leave it again, 5 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, whatever works for you. But the important thing is that you do it at least once a week, okay? So first the protein, you apply. Now this takes care of the porosity of the hair, and it helps the hair so you don't get any breakage. Trust me, your hairdresser will really appreciate you doing these treatments, but because when you go back to her for the service, your hair is gonna be in a nice shape that she can go ahead and continue that same service if that's what you want. So then I go ahead and I put the mask. This is a conditioning mask, this one from Enjoy. And then you apply it over the protein again. You work it through. And you clip it up. I put a baggie and I put my customers under the dryer with the bag for 20 minutes. You can do the same if you have a little heat cap at home. If not, you just, if you don't have time, at least leave it 5 minutes to 10 in the shower, and it'll work. It'll do what it needs to do, trust me. And then you just clip it up, and that's it. Okay, so now I went ahead and I rinsed the treatment out of my hair, and I'm gonna go ahead and I towel blotted my hair so it's not dripping. You don't want your hair to be dripping when you rinse the shampoo, because you want some product to go into your hair. So the same you do when you come out of the shower, you really towel blot your hair, and then you apply the conditioner, the leave-in, because you want to make sure that it absorbs. So go ahead and I apply it this side. I work it through, and then you can grab a pick or a brush and detangle your hair. If you can, start from, if you have very long hair or long hair at all, start from the bottom and you work your way up, okay? It's more sensitive to your hair. Now, it's better to use a comb, especially if, or this kind of brush, especially if the hair is wet, because when the hair is wet, it's a lot more sensitive than when it's dry. So be kind to your hair. So you go ahead and you detangle it. And then after that, you go ahead and you blow dry it. You put any styling product that you want, if it's curly mousse or gel, if it's straight, you know, volumizing shampoo, and then you go ahead and you fix it. So this is how my hair looks after I blow dried it with the treatment. I finished it with my finishing oil from HBL that I like. I use other ones, but after a treatment, this is the one that I really like to use. So I put very little on my hands, and then I work it through my hair. So you can see it's bouncy with everything that we use, the mask and the leave-in and the oil, it's still bouncy and it's shiny. So this is on this side. So I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did making this video. Click like and subscribe. And remember, healthy hair is shiny hair. Okay, thank you. Ciao.